What's up, Liron here. Today I want us to conclude the last 2 weeks of videos. I'm gonna talk about me going back to the fundamentals and also an upcoming interview with Cesar Santos. What's up, Liron here. Thank you for joining me in another video. And today is going to be a little different from the last 2 weeks in which we only did full painting processes. And I really feel like this kind of vlog video is due because I want to talk about the last 2 weeks. So I did this experiment of posting only real-time narrated painting processes. And I want to talk a bit about the experience of doing that. The feedback that I got and what I plan on doing next. Okay, so first off, it was really fun. Doing these full processes felt like the right thing. I actually learned a lot from narrating and talking as I am painting. It kind of forces you to think in a bit of a different way. It makes you reconsider the things you're doing real time and maybe even recognize some more mistakes or recognize alternative ways which you wouldn't have recognized unless you verbalize what you're doing, if that makes sense. Now, it's also very hard. Some of the focus does go to explaining what I'm doing. And I find actually that I didn't have this experience when teaching students live, when they're next to me. Maybe probably because you can convey a little more just by doing. And when the person is next to you, it's a little easier even to narrate, for me at least, personally. And with the video, it was a bit different, but I think that very quickly I became accustomed to it and became really fun. Now, I know not everyone's interested in these full processes, and there are a lot of series running on this channel that I want to continue, and I know a lot of people want me to continue, so just rest assured, this was kind of an experiment. I was trying just to see how or what the response is to that. One of my greatest insights was actually that the balance of the channel is what's important to me. You know, no matter what you're gonna do, people may not enjoy one aspect or another aspect of what you're doing. So the only thing that's left for me is to give as much of a variety as possible and do what makes me feel good and what makes me enjoy. Because you can't please everyone, and that's fine. So what I think we're gonna do next is I'm gonna take all of the insights and things that I gained from doing all of these videos real time and narrated, and I'm gonna incorporate it in a more well-balanced schedule. So we're going back now officially to the longer running series. I'm gonna have soon a Painting Masters episode, a really interesting one actually, about Qian Chung Wei's wife, Jasmine Huang, I think her name is. I still need to do my research, but she has amazing artwork that I plan on covering soon. I'm gonna cover some more SAA paints. I also have another brand of paints that I forgot its name that I wanna kind of open, unbox together with you and give it a try. So there are a lot of things that aren't full painting processes that I wanna go back to doing. However, I will incorporate that as well. So I'm gonna try or aspire to do maybe one of these full painting processes a week, or maybe the minimum one in every 2 weeks, but it's probably gonna be more than that. And I actually am curious, now is a good chance for me to get your feedback, so let me know. And I've been getting a lot of feedback, and it was mostly positive really about these full processes. So let me know again, if you still haven't, what you think of these kinds of things. But what I also think is most of us need a balance. So a bit of this and then a bit of that, maybe a lighter vlog video like this one, then going back to talking about some paints. So this is what I'll try and aspire to do, a bit of everything really. But my painting processes, for the most part, when I do a painting process, I'll try having it in real time. And by the way, it wasn't easy doing the real time thing for many different reasons. First off, it makes the videos much longer. So longer exporting time on my on Premiere, longer upload time to YouTube, so much more space taken on my Mac. So it just makes the whole thing a little more time-consuming and a little more, requires a bit more effort on my end. On the other hand, I don't need to narrate anything. I can just edit the video as it is. I don't need to think about where to cut out some parts or stuff like that. So that's really a positive. But on the other hand, yeah, it was challenging in that regard as well, which is why you saw that mess up with the video that I don't know why YouTube kind of cut it after 2 minutes. I had to re-upload it and it took so long. So hopefully that doesn't happen again. It was hopefully just a one-time thing. So that's that in terms of the last 2 weeks. Let me know your thoughts in a comment below. This comment form feedback is the most important. I try to look at what people respond to, what videos get the most comments, the most likes, the most shares. But aside from that, the qualitative feedback is really important for me, and I try to apply everything. And I read all of your comments. It may take me some time to get to them, but I read and reply to like 99% of them. So that's the first thing, the last 2 weeks. It's been a pleasure. Thank you for allowing me to try out this direction and for directing me there yourself. You actually helped me get there, and now we're gonna incorporate it in a more balanced way. Next up, I wanna talk about going back to fundamentals. So one of the things I've been thinking about a lot lately is the thing I aspire to reaching the goal to become one of the best I can in my field, I feel like I now need to revisit fundamentals a little more. So that means working more on my basic skills, basic drawing skills, drawing figures, drawing portraits, going for the gesture drawing, the hardest subjects there are, because I got comfortable painting and drawing these kinds of things that are not easy, but still it's not the same. Now I wanna, I'm not gonna take a break from watercolor, but I will do a lot more pencil studies and sketches. So that's something you're probably gonna see more of on Instagram and places like that. Here I'll probably preserve the watercolor momentum still. I'm actually in like 10 minutes, I'm gonna go out and paint outside. So I'm not quitting watercolor, but I do want to balance out working on some more fundamentals, which is drawing, measuring accurately, training my eyes to see shape and volume and mass and conveying shadow in a believable way, not just with painting media, but also with pencil and pen and working on those tough subjects. This is something I really want to devote more attention to, because I understand that all of this will go into my painting skills as well and will help me in the future. And I think my drawing skills are decent, but I could be doing much better. I'm still very challenged by figures, and painting makes it a little easier, and I always know I can just observe and measure and be careful about it, but I do want to develop my senses a bit more and help have more of that happen and come from muscle memory. So that's the thing I'm really excited about, and I'm going to share a bit more about soon. And another thing, so that's the second thing I wanted to talk about. Now, the third thing I wanted to talk to you about today is an upcoming interview with an artist I really appreciate and admire that I think many of you will find valuable. So I don't know if you're familiar with Cesar Santos. So I came across him like a while back, but only he really came onto my radar more seriously in the last 2 weeks. And immediately, as soon as I heard him speak, I knew I have to make that contact. So I contacted him. He was the best. He was like super responsive, and we set up an interview. We did the interview. I now just need to edit it, but just know that it's upcoming. So if you're familiar with Cesar Santos, I'm gonna link down his channel below. I think you're gonna really enjoy this one. We dive a little deeper on the philosophy of art and why we create and how we create and how we develop as artists. And then we go into some lighter topics as well. I think this interview will be a nice little break for everyone who just wants to listen, and you don't have to worry about watching, because you can just hear us speak. It's a conversation. It's kind of an interview, but it goes into deeper topics. So that's going to be really good. I'm going to also post it as a podcast episode, or my weekly podcast. By the way, if you're listening to my daily podcast, I'm really, really grateful for that, because it gets a lot of views recently. It's actually going to surpass, I think, the weekly podcast in like, I don't know, a month or so. So I really want to thank you for that. So these are the three things I wanted to share with you today. I really hope you enjoyed this kind of a vlog, and maybe it's a nice break from all the processes. And if you're really want more real-time processes, don't worry, I'm gonna do that. If you're sick of real-time processes, don't worry, we're gonna combine everything together, go back to the more normal schedule. But I will post at least, I think, once a week or once every week and a half or 2 weeks. Like one in four videos or five videos is definitely going to be a full painting process. At least that's what I'm going to aspire to. I want to thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I'm really grateful for that. And always let me know if there's anything you want me to talk about or, you know, discuss just verbally. I'm really reading all of the comments, even if it takes me some time to respond. I have it queued up, and I'm going over everything, at the very least reading, but I'll probably answer everything as well. So thank you so much, and I will see you again in another vid real soon.